They are already satisfied with their electronic configuration. They does not require any of the other point, negative part they doesn't need. For example, here it has formed hydroxide, right? This will exist in nature as Au only. If it exists in the other form, it will revert back to Au because of the complete electronic configuration. They are satisfied. But in case of these metals, they have the capacity, they are stable in their salt mixture. They are stable in their salt mixture. What are the salts? For example, they can form oxides, they can form sulfides, or they can form carbonates or phosphates, sulfates, etc., etc. They will be existing as ferrous sulfate. Okay, copper sulfate, sodium carbonate, sodium chloride. Why they are existing as a salt? Because they are stable. They are requiring something to satisfy their octet configuration. They are requiring some other part to satisfy their configuration. That is why NaBrs and Cl metals. Can you remember that? How they will exist? Who is donating? Who is getting?
Cl is donating.
They are sharing, right? One is having excess, the other one is having vacant. Okay, they are sharing and they are forming a covalent bond, right? That history, that story is happening in such metals. Okay, so these metals in nature, they will exist in a salt form. Combined state, that is called as the combined state. In that state only these metals will be stable. In that state only they will be stable. They will be having lower energy state. They will be in the lower energy. Suppose I am having from nature, I am getting ferric hydroxide. Okay? I want to remove this OH minus and I want to take pure iron. Okay, I am doing some process, I am taking the iron alone. I am left with elemental ion. This is called as elemental ion. Elemental ion. If I keep this after processing, remote processing, separation process, if I take the fresh ion, whatever I have obtained, if I leave it as such, tell me whether it will remain as such or it will get converted to ethereal form. Whether it will get converted into ethereal form? Definitely yes. Definitely yes. Because I told you that if it gets converted into elemental state, it will be having a higher energy. They will attain a higher energy. They will be in the higher state. This is not a stable state. This is an unstable state. This is an unstable state. They cannot stay with that energy. So they tend to revert back to the lower energy state. They tend to revert back to the lower energy state, which is the combined state. Which is the combined state. So what happens? They will again revert back to the formation of ferric hydroxide. This is why the metals are getting corroded, tarnished. What does it mean for tarnishing? Tarnishing. Blackening of the silver metal, copper metal. Okay, you will be drinking water with that copper bottle, right? How it will appear in the surface? If you wash that and after 2 hours, how it will appear? You can see some brownish or blackish coating over there. From where it is coming? From where it is coming? In the atmosphere. In the surrounding, they are observed. attack? You are not allowing somebody to attack you. Will you be get attacked? Somebody is standing simply and somebody is coming and hitting. What happened to him? What happened to him? He is standing simply. Somebody is coming and hitting. What happened to him? He will either fall down or something will happen. If somebody is standing and he is against whatever coming him, what will happen? The other person will get affected, right? The same thing is happening here. Okay, if you remain as such, you will be get. That is, you are having the intention. It depends upon the intention of that matter to get corroded or not, to get stabilized or not. Because of that intention only, you are the rusting or the corrosion of the metal is happening. Is that clear? Next one. What are the types of corrosion? What are the types of corrosion? We are having two types of corrosion. One is types of corrosion. Any doubt? Anybody having any doubt? Yes? One is dry or chemical corrosion and the other one is wet or electrochemical corrosion. Wet or electrochemical corrosion. What is the meaning for dry, wet? Dry, wet. Tell me whether the concentration of the metal will be same or not. Steel. Have you heard about the steel? Steel. What is composed of? They also will get dissoluted. As a result, don't allow atmospheric moisture or any element or any electrolyte to attack the lower layer of the metal. Let us assume that this is the metal surface. Okay, this is the metal surface, and I am having the oxide layer over here. Tell me whether anything can attack the metal. This is the metal layer. Can anybody attack the metal layer? Can anybody attack? In this case, it won't, because the full surface is being covered by the metal oxide. Suppose, tell me whether something can attack in this case. This is the metal surface. This is the oxide layer. This is the oxide layer. Tell me whether the attack of the metal can happen in this case. Whether it can happen? Yes, definitely. Something can come and attack the available metal surface. Something can come and attack the metal surface, because the surface is not completely covered with the metal oxide. The surface is not completely covered with the metal oxide. That is what happening in this case. The metal area is greater than the metal oxide. The metal area is greater than the metal oxide. That means free metal surface, availability of free metal surface is more. Availability of free metal surface is more than the metal oxide form. That is why further electrolyte or oxygen or moisture can come and attack the metal and convert that into oxide. Okay, because of that, we call that as non-protective, and it is porous. And it is porous. You should not forget about this. Okay, the metal oxide is, metal oxide is greater than the metal surface. It will act like a non-porous, and it will be protective. If the metal surface is greater than the metal oxide, that metal oxide will be porous and it will help for the corrosion. It won't be acting as a protective coating. Is that clear? A very, very important point. Okay? Not only this type of oxide layer will be formed, there can be a stable oxide layer. What is the meaning for stable oxide layer? I told you just now. Stable oxide layer means a stable oxide layer. Once it forms, once that metal oxide layer is formed, further oxidation won't happen. Is that clear? For example, what I told you? Can you imagine what is happening in your copper water bottle? Copper water bottle, whether it is getting porous, it is also getting corroded, right? Why you are getting tarnished? Why the color is getting tarnished? Blackening, that is nothing to call as tarnishing. Okay, formation of oxide layer is called as tarnishing. Okay, that is, it is forming an oxide layer which acts like a protective coating. In case of aluminium vessels also, you might have seen such formation, right? In case of aluminium vessels, okay? Also, this will happen in copper vessels, utensils, and also in case of the silver utensils also, this will happen. They won't get corroded, okay? The same oxidation is happening in iron. There we call it as corrosion. Here we call it as tarnishing. Because it is a stable oxide layer, it won't allow for the oxidation of the metal. Next one is the unstable oxidation layer. Next oxide layer is unstable oxide layer. What will happen if the oxide layer is unstable? In case of noble metals, already I mentioned in the beginning itself, if at all it will get oxidized, if at all they form a metal oxide, they will decompose. They will decompose. Why? Decompose into? Why they will decompose? what is happening. Iron easily will get oxidized. Yes or no? Iron will get oxidized easily. It will form Fe2 plus. Yes or no? Fe2 plus. And sulfur will combine with unbound ferrous sulfide, releases atomic hydrogen. Releases atomic hydrogen. This atomic hydrogen is not stable. This atomic hydrogen is not stable. They will have the intention to form a stable state. How that can be formed? They will combine with one more hydrogen atom. They will go in search of the other hydrogen atom which comes in contact with close contact of them. They will combine with this hydrogen and form hydrogen. Yes. Where this is happening? Where this is happening? Inside the metal. Inside the metal. Suppose here it is hydrogen gas is formed. Here we have already have studied about the crystal structure of metals. So no, already we have studied about the crystal structure of metals, right? So the metals will be having such kind of crystal structures and they may have some walls. They may have some walls. These hydrogen atoms, what will happen? They will occupy these voids. This hydrogen gas will occupy that voids. The gas is called as voids. So what happens? Since the gas occupies this area, as a result of this, the pressure increases. As a result of this, the pressure inside the metal increases. This, due to this pressure, there may be a chance for the metal to get cracked. There may be a chance for the metal to get cracked. This, the concentration of this hydrogen gas may lead to the formation of blisters. What is the meaning for blisters? A bubble filled with any gas. You can imagine the balloon. Okay, blisters you will be getting when you spill something caught in your kuppadangal. Something accumulated inside. Okay, something accumulated inside anything. So here that hydrogen gas blisters will be formed. As a result, the pressure increases. Because of the pressure, there may be a chance for the metal to get adjust itself. So when the crystal structure adjusts itself, there is a chance for the metal to get cracked. And one way or the other, this will happen inside the metal, not in the surface, not in the outer surface. This is happening inside the metal. You cannot see, you cannot visualize through your eyes. Okay, this will happen inside the metal. So one day or the other, this process keeps on continuing, and one day or the other, the metal will become brittle and it will totally break down. Totally, it will get damaged and it will break down. The same thing happens when you have decarburization. Decarburization. What do you remember when you hear carbon?
Carbon.
They will form, the similar process happen for them other two ways in which the liquid metal corrosion happens. That is, the dissolution of the solid metal when it comes in contact with the liquid metal. That is, dissolution of a solid metal by a metal. Liquid metal. Dissolution of a solid metal by a liquid metal. When a solid metal comes in contact with the liquid metal, automatically they will undergo corrosion. One way. Okay. Next one is, when a liquid metal penetrates deep into the solid metal. When a liquid metal penetrates deep into the liquid metal, that time also it leads to the liquid metal corrosion. This will happen only at the condition is not at regular room temperature. This is not happening at the room temperature. Liquid metal corrosion occurs only at
high room temperature.
Only at
high room temperature.